When it comes to slicing up chromatics, there are many different methods that people use to do so. Some people use SliceX, some people use Fruity Slicer, and some people even use DirectWave. But what if I told you that there's a secret fourth option, and that is Harmer? Harmer is one of FL Studio's built-in plugins, which is an additive synthesizer. And what's cool about Harmer is that you can drag and drop your own sounds in, and even images to make cool custom sounds. For example, here's what apparently I sound like in Harmer. Harmer has a wide variety of different capabilities, but I'm going to be showing you how to get chromatics to work in Harmer. Firstly, open up a SliceX patch with the chromatic you want to use. Since our chromatic is already sliced up, what we're going to do is click on this save icon and choose save sample as. Once your chromatic is saved, you're going to want to open up an instance of Harmer. Go through the presets and choose resynthesis. Then drag and drop in the chromatic file you just saved. Once it's done processing, you'll want to click on this arrow next to plain and choose both map audio regions to keys and map audio markers to keys. From here, the chromatic is already mapped out, but there's a few settings we'll need to adjust. Go to your advanced settings, turn safety and grain all the way up, and change the precision to perfect. In your image settings, change the level and frequency to cubic. Click on image time offset, and everywhere you see a little white arrow pointing next to it, you're going to want to click on that and turn the knob all the way up. This next part is optional, but if you want to add vibrato to your voice, go to pitch vibrato depth, adjust the curve to however you want, turn the depth all the way up, and the speed to about 135 milliseconds. And lastly, enable legato, so you can only have one note playing at once. And after that's done, you'll have something like this.
It is a spooky month!